Hello.
Hello. Very good afternoon to everyone present here. I am Avinash Kumar Dasoundhi, currently working with the performance and scale engineering team of Red Hat as an associate software engineer. So today I'm here to talk about distributed system analysis using Pbench, a tool which we use very frequently in our team to identify different bottlenecks and do the performance analysis. And so being a part of a performance team, I think performance analysis is very much important, and a great deal of effort is spent in testing the performance of any software before it gets released, right? So the interaction between hardware and software is really difficult to understand. So I think performance analysis is very much important, and that's why it's somewhere is an arc and art. So let's start with the presentation. So the first thing is, what is a distributed system? I know most of you guys are familiar with this, but let me give you a brief about it so that the persons who don't know can get an idea. So in simple language, we can say a distributed system is a system software in which components are located in a network computer, coordinate and communicate their actions by passing messages. They interact with each other in order to achieve a common goal. So these distributed systems are applications or systems that can be run on multiple networks within a network at the same time and can be stored on server also. So if you want to do a performance analysis of that distributed system, you need to know how each component is behaving, how each component is doing in that system. And I think it's cumbersome to run and log each tool available in Linux system and then analyze them. But I also agree, like, it's really important to do things like do the analysis of those tools to identify different bottlenecks across the system. So Pbench can help you out with those scenarios. We will see how in a while. So let's know about Pbench. I'm sure you guys must be curious about how it got its name. So Pbench is nothing but a combination of two words, Pbench, performance and benchmarking. That's how it got its name. So performance and it's a performance and benchmarking analysis framework which provide easy access to benchmarking and performance tools on Linux systems. We are frequently using this term benchmarking, so let me explain it a bit. So benchmarking is nothing but it's a set of measuring performance tools and comparing the results of one system with another one or a widely accepted standard through a unified procedure. This unified method of evaluating system performance can help us to answer many questions like, is our system is performing at is supposed to be? Is our system is capable of doing task A? What drivers should we use to get the optimal performance out of it? So sometimes benchmarking and stress testing are very much essential to optimize the system and eliminate any performance bottlenecks in the system. Getting back to Pbench, so it also acts like a harness that allows the data collection from a variety of tools while the system is running a benchmark. Pbench has some inbuilt benchmarks that allow to run some common benchmark, but the data collection can be run differently as well as with benchmarks also. So one way to understand the system performance is running workload on it. What workload means here is, when you are putting your application or software in a large scale and making it to do more and more of what it's supposed to do, means taking it to its limits and doing the performance analysis during that phase. Sometimes the workloads that can be run on the system is actually present for the testing purpose, but in most of the cases, however, one has only canned benchmarks that can simulate the actual workload. So Pbench can help you out with this by providing, it has the ability of providing automation to run the benchmark, and collect system information. So storing results and cataloging it can provide you some regression analysis, which helps the system to improve. And above all, it helps us to understand the characteristics of a system. Okay. So during its, like when the Pbench is running a benchmark and doing the data collection, it is standardizes the collection of telemetry and configuration information also. Now the main question is, why Pbench? You guys must be wondering about, like, there are many tools in the market which can do this. Like, what's so special about it? I know there are many available tools to look at the system stat, but we wanted a benchmark or a framework which can allow us to collect and visualize the data of the stat, including system information, while the system is running a workload to find out the different performance bottleneck at scale. Okay. So it also, like, it helps you to archive the data, whatever the data they collected. It archives it for later consumption and analyze it. Like, it helps you to analyze the data by providing visualizations and data comparison. It also allow the indexing of data into Elasticsearch for get a time series graph. And you can also visualize the data through Kibana and Grafana. It also provides a way to see the graphs. If you want to see the graphs on the web interface, it also provides that. Moving on to next slide. The components of Pbench. So it's basically divided into three parts. The Pbench agent. So it's a package consisting of scripts handling execution of tools and benchmarks. So it is the package that is responsible for providing commands when you are running a benchmark across one or more system, while properly collecting the configuration of those system logs and define telemetry from various tools. The second one is Pbench server. It is responsible for archiving the results tarball, indexing them, and unpacking them for display. So the data which we are getting from the agent is going to land up on our server, and it went through different post-processing. So when the data got into our server, it got automatically unpacked. The server will index it and unpack it for the user to visualize. The third one is web server. It is for displaying various graphs and results in web interface. Although we are indexing the data to Elasticsearch to get a time series graph or to visualize through Kibana or Grafana, we want a way so that user can see the results instantly as soon as the data get into the server. So this is for that. Let's discuss about the architecture. So you can see there are different machines which have agent install on it, and they are collecting the data. They are sending the results to a server by a simple command, that is Pbench move result. On server, the data which we got from the agent went through different post-process things like archiving, indexing. From there, it goes from two places. The first one is Elasticsearch, as I told you, for indexing. And to get a time series data, you can visualize it through Kibana or Grafana. The second one is web server for instantly seeing the results on web interface. So what are the available benchmark scripts and tools? There are many scripts or benchmarking scripts specifically in Pbench, but we mostly often use these benchmarks. The user benchmark. Let's suppose you want to run something which is not already packaged up as a benchmark script. So what will you do? It will use this, you can use this Pbench user benchmark. So what it will do, it will take your benchmark as a argument. It will start the collection of tools, invoke it, stop the collection of tools, and the post-process the results. Pbench FIO. So the main Pbench FIO was created to automate the sets of FIO and including the calculation of statistics of throughput and latency. So you can run sequential read and write as well as random read and writes with different block sizes with this benchmark script. The third one is Pbench uperf. So the main purpose of Pbench uperf is to characterize the capacity of your overall network infrastructure to support the required number of traffic So the main purpose of Pbench uperf is to characterize the entire capacity of your network infrastructure to support the induced amount of traffic given by the distributed storage by using multiple network connection in parallel. So there are many other benchmarks also, but we mostly often use these benchmarks. Now the available tools. So Pbench use these tools to get different data metrics from the system and to do the performance analysis and to find different bottlenecks. So what it does is like it collects all the data, it accumulates it, and it packages it as a result tableau and send it to server for processing. So some of the tools are SAR, that is system activity report, that gives you an overview of the system. The second one is IOSTAT. It monitors the input-output devices. The third one is MPSTAT. It gives you the CPU utilization of the system. PIDSTAT. So it's monitor the an individual process managed by the kernel and gives the reports out of it. VMSTAT. That is again virtual memory statistics. PERF. It is yet another tool for performance and benchmarking. So where do I get Pbench? Pbench is currently available via RPMs. So if you want to give it a try, you can do it. And if you want to look at the source, you want to contribute to Pbench, here is the GitHub link. You can check it out. So this is some sample graphs which we get from tools data visualization and benchmarking visualization. I will show you a short demo, like how do we do things in Pbench. Sorry. So first thing, let's suppose this system has Pbench agent installed in it. You have to install the tools from which you want the data metrics. So you can do something like Pbench register tool. And it will install the tool for you. And if you want to install a bunch of tools at once, you can also do this. It will install those tools for you. If you want to clear those tools, you can use Pbench. Clear tools. It will remove the tools. So let's install all the tools first. Now your system is ready to collect the data. Let's run a simple benchmark. So as I told you, if you want to run something that is not already packaged as a benchmarking script, you can use this Pbench user benchmark like this, like Pbench user benchmark. Like this, you can run your own benchmark, custom benchmark. I don't have right now. So let's run a simple benchmark. So what it will do is like it will sleep that benchmark for 10 seconds. It will observe your system for those tools. It will collect the data from those tools and it will give it to you. So it's collected all the data, and if you want to send the data to the server, you just need to do pbench move result, and it will package those data as a tarball and it will send it to server. So let me show you how it looks like on the web server. So I've already ran a test with more data. So you can see here. Let's this one. So these are the tools which we have registered to get the data, and it is showing here. If you want to see IO stat, it will show something like this on the web. Let's see another one, like the MP stat. So this is how it looks, the results. I am again here, sorry. Yeah, so that's all. Any questions? Yeah. Sorry, I can't hear you. Just wait.
Excuse me. The basic question is like you are showing it for a demo for a single system. So I would like.
Can you speak a bit louder? Sorry.
So it is audible now? Hello?
Yeah.
So I would like to understand, is there any way to see it for multiple systems? Because in a region-wise, I'm having a two-system distributor. I want to see a collective log. So what your demo is giving me a sense like, I'm getting a single log of what I can see it in CLI, converted into some GUI page, and just seeing that.
So let's suppose if you want to collect the data from a, you have 10 nodes, and you want to collect the data for all 10 nodes. What you need to do is like you need to install agent on all those nodes. You can like install the tools over those nodes, and when you run a pbench user benchmark or fire or uperf, you can give the destination of that inventory file. It will take the IPs of those nodes from there, and it will take the data out of it, and it will package it as a single result, and it will show you.
Exactly, so that is the intention. So I would like to understand, is there any dashboard kind of a thing in the single place itself, in the single page itself?
So
I wanted to see
that. So the data is ingested in Elasticsearch, so you can use Grafana to see those nodes. Like you just need to select the node to which you want to see the data, and it will show the data to that node.
So may I ask one question? Why you not included those kind of things in your PPT?
Sorry, because can't hear you.
So may I ask one request to you? Because the topic itself, we are interested to see that things only.
Yeah.
So we have got disappointed by seeing a single node. So you have any pictures or you have any images to show that kind of a dashboard?
Right now, I don't. Let me see my system. I will share with you.
Okay, fine. So this is your Red Hat ID, right? Shall I have a contact with you too? I can see some Red Hat email ID there.
Yeah, you can contact me in that email ID, yeah.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, hi.
So if we have to run pbench across a multiple set of nodes, I'll have to individually run pbench across each of these nodes, is it? Or is there any way I can easily orchestrate?
You don't need to run on all those nodes. You have a master node. You can run the user benchmark or any benchmark in that node. It will collect the data from all those nodes and it will get back to you.
Okay. So the master will orchestrate tests across all nodes.
Yeah.
All right.
So if I can see it, it's mostly agent based.
Sorry.
Hello. Is it audible now?
Yeah.
So if I look at it, it's mostly an agent-based, kind of tracking your system metrics, right? So I want to, just now, I think you said it's kind of, your master agent collecting the data from all this, slab nodes, right? So it's basically you are pulling all these system metrics from all your slabs.
Yes.
So is there a mechanism that you can push all the, system metrics from your slab nodes to master instead of pulling it?
You can do that. It's up to you.
But then you need to build your slave agents in such a manner that the agents.
No, you can directly go to the slave machine. You can directly push the data to a server. No, you just need to change the configuration file where to send the data.
But then if you have 1,000 nodes, then I cannot go to 1,000 nodes each and every node and I can push it, right?
So through the inventory file or through the Ansible, you can do that. Like you can change the configuration file at once.
Okay. So my next question is, if this agent will provide the system metrics based on the different processes or the application running in, or there's a whole nodes information will send. Just an example, let's say I have a system and when I execute all these tools, it might give me just CPU usage of let's say 90%. So will it also distribute the CPU usage 90% of different processes or the different applications that it is running?
Can you repeat it? I didn't get
okay.
it.
So let's say I have 5 applications running in a node, right? Yeah. So when I execute these tools, so it will give me, let's say 60% CPU uses. Will it also segregate, which application using how much of a CPU?
It will tell you which process is actually taking that CPU. It depends whether it show the application and name or not.
No, but I am interested in to see, let's say X application using, X amount of CPU.
Okay. So this is something like it's based on the data which is collected. It's not like you can monitor the live system. So let's suppose at this time your CPU usage was this, your memory usage was this, and this process is doing this. So you can visualize the data in this. Like in the benchmark result, you will get it. So it will produce 2-3 types of data. The first one is this. JSON data, it will create a CSV file as well as it will create a summary file also that will have that process name or application name which you are talking about.
Okay, my last question might be
yeah.
So if you look at now market, so you have many such kind of tools. Okay, I can name it few. You have Sightline, you have Nagios, you have there are many tools. Now how it is different from other tools? I didn't see much difference in this tool, let's say an example of Sightline or an Agios.
Okay, so the first thing is I don't know about much tools, whether they provide the automation of workload or not. It can produce or simulate the workloads. It's a property of Pbench, like it can collect the data while the system is running any benchmark. So maybe these are the advantages of Pbench among all other tools out there.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks for the talk.
Yeah.
So one of the things about distributed systems is, the network throughput.
Yeah.
Right? So for example, let's say, I'm keeping one server in one rack, another server in another rack, and like that, right? So I would like to measure, what is the network throughput between, I want to transfer large file from one node to another node and see how it performs.
Okay.
Is it possible to do it through Pbench,
Means you that want kind of to measure the throughput when you are sending a data from one server to another.
Right.
If Pbench is running during that time,
yeah,
it can identify that.
No, so does Pbench have built-in test for that? Can it simulate that workload?
No, I guess no. Not
okay.
right now.
Okay, not right. How old is this tool? When was this started, this tool?
I guess it's been 2 years, maybe.
Okay, it's a relatively new tool then.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
It's mainly an internal tool which we use for different purposes, different team. So for a user who is outside Red Hat, if they provide us like what they want more from this tool, we are happy to help.
Okay, so we can provide at the GitHub
Yeah, it's there.
At the GitHub.
Can you see it? Yeah.
So I went there. So okay. At that I can create an issue or I can request.
Yeah, you can open an issue. No problem.
I can open an issue.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
So a couple of questions. The first thing is like, hello. So assume a situation I'm having a data center where I'm having a virtualized environment.
Okay.
I'm having a host machine. Along with that, I'm having 4 or 5 VMs on top of it. So
do I still need to run the 2 times kind of a duplication, right?
I'm not sure right now. Maybe I need to take a look and we'll get back to you.
So is this kind of a testing has been done till time, or you don't have any idea?
Actually, I'm in the tools team, so I developed this team. I am not sure whether some team has tested it already or not. So maybe there are some other people. I will ask with them. And will let you know.
Fine. So is there anybody in the
there are other people.
A second question.
Yeah.
So basically when you are talking about these agents and servers, right? So you are showing some graphical interpretation. So is there the client's agents which are just collecting the information, right? And you are having a 2 commands to send this information to the server. What is the point in keeping this kind of information only in the agent? Anyway, we need to send the server, right? You can have a single command with that we can directly send the information to server. Why we are having the agent there?
It depends on user to user. For us, like there are many users who want to send the data to a particular server. For it was easy to install the agent and server on the same machine.
I'm asking a situation. Anyway, I'm going to send to the server. I'm not going to do anything with the information what is this agent is collecting. Instead of having 2 commands, can you have a single command so that the information will be directly given to the server?
So there is only 1 command. You are using pbench move result, and it will get the result, collected result to server.
That we are collecting, I am giving 1 command, right? That itself it can move the data, right?
Yeah, but it depends on user. Let's suppose you want only the SAR data, or someone who wants the IO stat and SAR both. So for those, we have given those options.
Okay, I can ask in a different manner. Instead of sending these results to server, only I am keeping this data locally. What is the use for?
What?
The objective is to send this data to the server only, right?
You can visualize it locally also. You don't need to send it. It's not mandatory.
Okay, I can have a server in the local itself. I can see the results.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's how I configure it actually in my local system. Any more questions? Okay. Thank you.